Today, I'm going to show you how to create your own characters in EU5. So first, we need to create a mod folder, or you can use an existing one if you have one. And then inside our mod folder, let's make a new folder called main_menu. And then inside that, we'll make another one called setup. And inside that, we'll add one more named start. Now go to the same folder within the games files and copy over the three files character, dynasties and countries. Now we need to open the characters file within our mod. This is where we can add new characters. And the important rule here is that every character has to appear directly underneath their parents. Think of it like a top to bottom family tree. I'm going to replace the King of Sweden. The easiest way is to search for King Magnus, copy his whole character block and paste it. Then I can edit the details for my new character. I'm keeping his parents the same here, just to make this example simple. You can have different parents, you just have to make sure they are listed above your character. And using this same pattern, you can add spouses or children. We can also add our own dynasty that we will create next. Save the characters file and open the dynasties file. Copy and paste the block of another dynasty and fill in the details of your new one. We do need to create the appearance of our character, but we'll get to that later. First, we need to open the countries file. As I mentioned earlier, I'm replacing the King of Sweden. So once again, we need to search for Magnus and replace him with our new character. If you created a spouse, you can add them under consort. We can also edit the ruler term, adding in our new character's term and setting an end date for Magnus. The regnal number is just the number after a ruler's name, like Henry VIII. It tells the game which Henry they are in the line of succession. We now also need to replace all entries of Magnus with our new character. This will give us the titles for Norway and Scania. Save that file, and now we need to set up our localization. Inside the main_menu folder, create a new folder called localization. Inside that, make your language folder. For us, that will be English. Now copy the character_names_dynamic file from the base game. Drop it into your mod's English folder and add your character's name to it. If you created a dynasty, you will also need to copy over the dynasty_names file and do the same for your dynasty name. We can now create our character's appearance, so load the game up in debug mode and once in game hit the tilde key. The console should pop up and then we need to type portrait_editor. Press the tilde key again to get rid of the console. You can design your character and once you are finished, hit the copy persistent DNA button. Now open up a program like Notepad and paste the DNA, as we will need this in a bit. Back within our mod, we need to add a folder called in_game, and inside there add another folder called common, and inside that folder one more named persistent_DNA. Now go to the same folder within the games files and copy over the file custom_characters. Within that file, copy and paste a DNA block from another character and edit that for your new character. We can now copy the genes from the DNA we saved earlier and paste them here. The last thing we need to do is add clothing, hair and accessories for our character. So within the main menu folder of our mod, we need to create a folder called GFX. And then in the GFX folder, we need to create one called portraits. And then lastly, portrait modifiers. Then copy over the file historical_chr from the same location within the game files. And once again, we can just copy and paste the existing block of another character and edit that for our new character. Under DNA modifiers is where you can add in things like hair and clothing, simply by copying the accessory block from any of the game's files. So whether you want body paint, hairstyles or clothing, all you need to do is copy over the accessory block. If you found this video helpful, then please hit the like button, but thanks for watching and until next time.